Welcome to today's vlog. I'm in Santa Monica right now. It's been quite the morning and I finally got here. I kind of got here later than I expected, but I'll get into that a little further into the video. And I'm just in one of these sort of like surfside, like beachy type shops. I've never really been to one of these before. I kind of wish I had money so I could have got something. I'm really leaning towards one of these like companies. If I had the money, I'll show you. I like the whole like visco preppy avant basic sort of aesthetic. Like this one has a flower and this one has like a little sunny smiley face, that's what it's called. And then this is so cute for like the fall time, and this one as well because of the color of it. And then they have the infamous lifeguard hoodies over here, but these are like the original ones because we're like actually in Santa Monica right now. Look at these little baby bags. I have my backpack on right now, but these are the slings. So they're sort of like a crossbody backpack. And it's adorable. I like the rainbow on this one. But they have a whole rack of jean shorts, but then official licensed lifeguard product. I feel like the material is good for the beach because I guess it just doesn't soak up water that much. But it's like lace material. I don't know. These are really short. I still have to get the Pamela Anderson one, but they don't have my size. This is sort of close, except this is like a corally color, but like style-wise it is.
I'm at the beach right now, and thank God for my handy tripod. I just stuck it into the sand. It just has a whole blue sky. Maybe I might further it back to get some like more beachy view. But I'm setting up my shop. There's like no type of shade, but I guess it's kind of good because I want to get a tan anyways. So I like thought of doing stuff like this for a while. I thought it was one of those things that like, I don't know, I never got around to doing it, you know? But then I just saw like inspo pictures on Pinterest, and it was like some chick doing yoga by the beach. Like that was literally just it. Like she just like looked at some pictures on Pinterest and they added it to my board. I was telling my therapist how I thought that was like one of the coolest things ever. And something told me I really wanted to do it now. Even though I don't have my mat, even though I don't really have like yoga-esque clothing or stuff like that, that's something I'll get later on. But just so weird to me to do something like this because I remember like when I would meditate, when I would journal, when I would manifest, I would listen to like ocean noises, and to be able to like do all that but with like the actual ocean in front of me is just so surreal. And I'm just so grateful to be living somewhere like this where just it's like the ocean's an hour away, and I just feel like dang, like I feel like going to the beach today on a September or on a September day, you know? And like I was like walking around here and I stopped by like, you know, like the surf shop, and I was like listening to music on my walk. And I was listening to this song by Miley Cyrus. I listened to a lot when I was like back in New York, and when it first came out, it was really, really difficult time for me because it was sort of like trying to adjust to like the whole like turning 20, like I like getting ready to enter post-grad life and all that stuff. And it was so weird to like listen to that song when I was by the beach and like walking around in like the beachy area of town. And I was also just like eating my Uncrustable and just like thinking about how simple things can be, but just how meaningful they could also be. And I guess that's sort of like what I'm gonna be journaling about later, is the fact that you can make the most of having little things, you know? Like me being homeless, but me thinking to myself that like being homeless is such a large factor of like what I'm struggling with right now. But like the fact that I'm like I'm here in California and like quite literally living my life like the Pinterest board that I imagined, and even doing things that I haven't really imagined or thought much about, but then being able to do it and enjoy it so much is like one thing I'm forever grateful for. And I feel like that's what I kind of want to close out the video with later. It's just like with my affirmations and quotes, saying stuff about gratitude. And I feel like it's so difficult, especially when you're in a situation like being homeless and like having little to no money, about gratitude and just like having something to be grateful for. And it is reasonable, because unfortunately you don't have much when you're in a situation like that. So it's like, when you don't have much, how can you be grateful for anything? I feel like the little things is what's one of those things that you should be grateful for, especially if you have little amount of things. It's just such a beautiful day. I'm so grateful. So I just finished doing some yoga and some meditation. I don't really know that much about yoga. I did it when I was a little girl. I remember I took like yoga classes in elementary school, and meditation, it was just so surreal to literally just be like legs crossed, like butterfly pose sort of, and then like just like having my brain be on pause for a bit and just like hearing actual ocean noises and not just some like white noise from Spotify. It was just like the ocean's like literally right in front of me, and just like thinking to myself, like, I hope that if I get an apartment, like ideally I want to be in Hollywood, I want to be like where all the stars are, I want to be where all the movie studios are. I really want to be in that sort of like film industry, like celebrity sort of environment. But I'm really thinking of looking into the apartment in Santa Monica. Like, how nice would that be to just be able to be near the beach, be in like a beachy sort of town, and just like walk around and experience it all just like a couple blocks away from your home, you know? And I think that would be a good thing for me to just like have more outward peace in my life. I feel like this is the most at peace I've been in a while, because I'm alone, and I've been like, I've been alone multiple times since, you know, last time I've been in out of peace. But just like being alone at the beach is just such a different experience. It's early in the morning, it's like not even lunchtime yet, and just like not that many people, and just like it's all to me, it's all to myself, and just it's like I couldn't be more happy to do something like this. I am leaving the beach right now, and I just had the most horrible thought, and I hate it when my brain does that. But like, it's so hard to walk in sand, right? And the sand is beyond scorching hot. And I thought to myself, wow, it would be god awful if someone got lost in the desert. If there's nothing but this type of sand and heat. Ayo, Jane Marie, why does your brain do this to you? But enough of that dark note. I'm leaving the beach out of respect of the people like near me. I didn't just like vlog a recap, but it was such a great like morning and just a great thing to do for myself. The only thing that'll change is probably like maybe getting some stuff that I might like invest in. Like, for example, like a portable radio speaker, like the old-fashioned ones. The possible yoga mat for when I want to do, intend to go to the beach just to do yoga, or mostly for yoga. I feel like an umbrella is so excessive, but I really needed one of some sort. Like, literally build myself a tent. I get a Target tent and just build one, because the heat is like beyond unbearable.
Hope my feet don't get blisters and it can be hot as steam. Walking on my shoes along with the sidewalk. I think I'm going to walk it a lot. Just for fun. I think I'm going to head to like a McDonald's or something to get like something to eat. I don't know what exactly I want, because I have something at points. And I can get either a large iced coffee or McChicken. I don't know. I'll think about it when I get there. But right now, I kind of just want to explore the boardwalk on my own, put in my headphones, and just enjoy the Hannah Montana-esque sort of vibe to it. And also, they did the Stranger Things season 3 premiere here. And that was something I wish I could go back in time and just experience myself, like somehow manage to get it like through to like the press people and just be like, hey, invite me. But it's smaller than I thought it would be, like much smaller,
But it is still pretty cute. I hope to go one day. Maybe as like a date or something. That'll be really cute.
I'm almost heading back home. I just like had such a great day. Like I love shopping and like getting new stuff and clothes and makeup and stuff like that, but I didn't really have money. So I did window shopping, just look around. There's some stores that I haven't really looked around in a while, and just like the malls I usually go into, they don't have these stores, so just so like strange to see all these stores in one area. You know, right now I'm in the shopping center, but then there's a whole like shopping block with all these different like stores and stuff. And I just want to say that I'm just like so grateful for like the ability to just like many like affirmations I'm gonna say. I know I was gonna say them to like the end of the video, but I just have to say them now because it's just like one of those things that you take yourself back and just realize it's just like I said, simple things, but also things that are like really, really like should not be taken for granted. Like besides the fact that like, oh, I'm grateful to be alive, like grateful to have the mobility and ability to just be alive and just do functions of being alive, you know, like so grateful to be able to like have the mental, emotional capacity to get out of bed and do sort of things like this. Being able to like physically do these things, like walk around and sit at the beach and be able to stay in the sun for a while. Be able to just like walk around just for fun, even if I have no money. And like the only reason I got that iced coffee is because I had the app. But other than that, I didn't have a penny to spend on that iced coffee. You know, and just like looking at all this stuff and just thinking about like how excited I am for when I finally get my apartment, I could have like more clothes to put in my apartment, and just thinking about all the trips I plan on doing next year and hopefully like saving up for a trip this year. Just like thinking about all this sort of stuff and just thinking about how quickly life could go on by and how quickly life could change. Like thinking about the fact that I've been here for like about like, let's say about 3 months. I moved here like early mid-June. It's September, early September. So it's like about 3 months. And it's crazy because it's like, I feel like I sometimes forget that I'm in Los Angeles, Hollywood, and I'm so far away from everything I've known and my friends and like the life that I used to live, you know? And just like sometimes there's been times I feel this feeling of stuckness and this like being like, holy crap, like I'm stuck here, like I don't know when I'm gonna go back to home, New York, or just like I just really miss like a few of my really close friends. I feel like I'm missing out on life. I just feel like I'm not necessarily missing out on life back home. I just feel like I'm missing out on the life that like a lot of people I know are happening to be living, you know. And I'm creating the life for myself, and I was telling my therapist about this, and she was just telling me, like, it was a couple sessions ago, she's reassuring me about the fact that it's like, it's just like, it's just understandable, and she did really take into account the reasons why I want this normalcy, because a lot of normalcy is just like basic human needs or just basic things that like most 20-year-olds have, like for example, like a better living situation, access to food, and just like stable households, like stuff like that is just like that normalcy. But then she's also telling me about like in other aspects of just like the coolness of just not being normal in comparison to like my old classmates and my friends, which I was like, yeah, I guess you're right. I guess it's kind of cool just to like have such a different life than them, you know, and sort of just sort of like have like this like mindset of just like, I feel like a lot of people are kind of afraid of, which I personally was afraid of like post-grad life and being like, now what? Like, what am I gonna do? And just like thinking to myself, I could do whatever I want. Like, I could, what can I do? You know, like, I could literally do anything, because it's like, I'm not in school anymore, and mainly my main responsibility is work, which I'm really putting in the effort to, but also I'm prioritizing my well-being and stuff, is like, with the fact that I literally could just like, just go to the beach and not have to worry about like homework or anything like that, you know, or go to like whatever place I want, like literally just go to like any place I want to go to anytime I want, any time of day, like with the exception of work, just like being able to do that and be able to vlog. And like literally thinking to myself that like I was on the beach, I was laying on the towel, I was putting like my tanning lotion, and I was like laying there, I go, this is a Friday in September and I'm on the beach laying down, and like I don't have that first few weeks of school
anxiety that I usually have every year. Just it's like, oh my god, is the class too hard? Did I get the messed up? Did I do the homework right? Do you think I'm right for this? I feel like that's something I felt a lot, like almost every year of school, of just like this nervousness. But I feel like for the first time I don't have that, you know? Which is so strange to think about, because I feel like it occurs to me every few times that I'm just, it's like, I should be in school right now, but I'm not in school right now. Like, I'm not on the desk or I'm not doing homework right now, which I do kind of miss, but for obvious reasons, I'm not necessarily doing that right now with my life. But I do have to finish up my courses. I've been a little delayed on finishing them up. I dedicated myself. I told myself that, like, on my day off, like, in, like, a day or two, I think on Monday, that I could just, like, wake up early, eat breakfast, do like 2 hours, as much as I could do for 2 hours, and just finish it if I could get my certification and not be so hard on myself that I'm a little delayed on that. Because there's one, there's no due dates, and two, just it's like I'm doing the best I can. So that's my whole ramble in the middle of the mall. I think I'm just gonna head back because I need to check the time, because it takes a while to get back. So I just hope I could just get back, I could just freshen up, and then by the time I'm all done with that, like, it's gonna be towards dinner time, so I'll eat something yummy with my food, maybe catch up with my friends, because I don't really see my friends today, because I kind of just, like, left to go to the beach really early, and they were all sleeping, so I'll be walking towards the bus wherever it is, but also enjoying such a nice day.